So we, I am going to discuss the rice residue management. Basically, in rice feed system. Dear friends, as you know very well, that the we have no any crunch of productivity or production nowadays. But the sustainable production system is a difficulty. This is the challenge. And as an agriculturist, we have always challenged to feed the growing population, but the nowadays challenge is the sustainable, to feed the sustainability, to feed this growing population with the sustainability. Sustainability in terms of production, sustainability in terms of economic, sustainability in terms of soil, sustainability in terms of ecology. So all these, we have to face these challenges and we have to work under this system. And if you see, these are the three principal indicators of non-sustainability of agricultural system. Soil erosion, that is, because we are observing here, every year we are applying phosphorus, balance use of, in the research areas also, balance use of NPK. And phosphorus are being applying every year. But the recovery is only 20%, 80% is remain into the soil. But where this goes, this is the question mark. Where this phosphatic fertilizer, because this is the this will fix into the soil, but where this goes? This goes through the soil erosions. Soil organic matter declining, that is also one of the this sustainability, because the organic matter is key to the productivity or production potential. To harness the production potential. So organic matter is declining very sharply. And we are observing here, even in the long-term fertility experiment, when it was started at Pandagar, the organic matter content was more than 1%. But now it has come to down 0.63%. So organic matter everywhere, in every field, organic matter is declining. And salinization is the one of the also problem which is creating into the country. And these problems are mainly caused by the different activities we are adopting into the production system. And the one of that one is the tillage and the tillage related. These problems are soil organic matter, because if injudicious use of tillage operation, injudicious tillage operation that causing with the carbon burning. And the more tillage, more carbon burning is there. We are observing that in the soil organic matter. That's why the soil organic matter is declining. Please, I request to all of you, please mute yourself, because some problems are coming in between. And the soil structure degradation is also because the most of the tillage operations are being done on the surface of the soil, only 10 to 15 centimeter. So the proper aggregation is not there, and these problems are occurring also. Water and wind erosion due to of these injudicious use of tillage operations. Water erosion, we are observing water erosion is there, wind erosion is and erosion is there. Reduce the water natural infiltration or natural drainage system, which is lacking nowadays, because due to of this only the surface manipulation of the soil. Surface sealing is there, crusting is there, soil compaction due to only manipulation on the surface of the up to maximum of 20 centimeter. So soil compaction is also there. And other problem mainly caused by the insufficient return of the organic material, either in terms of organic manure or in terms of residue or in terms of whatever organic sources are there. That is, we are not returning, we are not applying. Then the monocropping and monoculture. So the most of the places, even I have visited several countries and 5, 6, 7 countries I have visited. Monocropping may be there, but the crop rotation, proper principle of crop rotation, most of the country they are adopting. They are taking, if monocropping is there, only one crop they are taking, But 1 year they are taking maize, 1 year, another year they are taking soybean or any pulses. So this system, but in our country, if you say either rice wheat system is there, rice system is there. And the most of the condition, this monoculture are being there. So this should be avoided. Another problem, if you see. Somebody's voice is creating problem. Please mute yourself. Please, all of you, mute
yourself. Dear participants, please mute your mic.
Mehriya bhi judi.
Hello?
Yes, sir. Now. Yes, sir. Proceed, sir.
Yeah. So, if you see the, definitely there was a need and the need of the, to feed the growing population, the this food grain production that has increases, and that's good. That was the need of that time, and that is always needed. But along with this food production, if you see the micronutrient deficiency, first nitrogen, macronutrient, nitrogen deficiency, then the micronutrient, zinc deficiency, iron deficiency, phosphorus deficiency, and so on. So these deficiencies are being occurring nowadays. It has been observed that the most of the soils, 50% soil, they are deficient in the micronutrient. If they are not deficient even, but the response of almost all the micronutrients are nowadays there. And as Dr. Pandya has told that I am looking after the chief general manager of the university farm. It's the biggest farm of the country, not only the country, Asia, and the second largest farm of the world. So the 6,000 acre we are observing there, the most of the farmer, we used to give them the 5,000 to the farmers for the rental basis. And the big farmers, most of the big farmers, they are applying the consortia of micronutrients. So the response of these micronutrients are being coming. Otherwise, if you see also, there are the mining of the nutrients from the soil. Whatever we are applying, we are mining much more than we are applying. And especially the mining of the micronutrients are being there. So these, other factors that currently affect the sustainability of agriculture system is the changing climatic scenario. So aberrant weather condition we are being observing. This year very less rainfall was there. Last year the sufficient rainfall during the winter season was there. We had applied only one irrigation or two irrigation to the wheat crop. But this year only little bit rainfall was there, and the we have been applying the continuously and pumping the water from the groundwater and to apply the wheat crop. So decreasing the supply of the labor of the, this is also, and not only the labor, supply of the labor, even the management of the human power is a very difficult challenge nowadays, which I am facing. So, and the decreasing the water supply of agriculture, if you see the water table, earlier it used to be very, very shallow water table at the Pannagar even. So 2-3 feet, after digging up 2-3 feet, water comes up. But nowadays it's close to the 30-35 feet. So decreasing the water supply of agriculture and water table is going down also. Decreasing farm size and the need of intensification, because we cannot go the vertically, because the farm size is limited and the population is increasing. So we can go only the vertical, we can go for the only enhance the productivity and intensification. And injudicious use of fertilizers, mostly farmers, they are applying nitrogenous fertilizers. And most some of the farmers, they are applying phosphatic and the potassic fertilizers also. But the micronutrient fertilizers, most of the farmers, they are not being applied. Most of the farmers, they are not being... Still there is some problem. Please,
participant, please mute your mic.
Please mute yourself.
पार्टिसिपेंट
पे जाओ, देखो
पार्टिसिपेट को तो आ रहा
ये देख, ये जो करोगे यहाँ पे ये हटा दो, वहां से आ जाएगा बंदा।
प्लीज प्लीज म्यूट योरसेल्फ, ऑल ऑफ यू आई एम रिक्वेस्टिंग, प्लीज म्यूट योरसेल्फ, अदरवाइज वी कांट डिस्कस। एंड so injudicious use of fertilizer, mainly nitrogenous fertilizer, farmers are being applied. So these are the causes which the sustainability affected. And another problem nowadays which can be addressed very well, this is actually my main topic of discussion today, that the generation of the surplus crop residue, which can, this is the problem nowadays, but the problem can be addressed very well and very easily can be addressed. And this is the, actually, if you are addressing this problem, the several problem can be addressed along with this one. If you are adding the, we'll discuss, if you are adding these residues, so several problem can be addressed. Currently, if you see, the 686 million ton crop residue per year, and out of which the 205 million ton crop residue per year, this is the surplus crop residue, and 135 million ton crop residue are being burned. So this is very much problematic, and the mostly burning are being done in the Western UP, Punjab, Maharashtra, Haryana, and some part of the Andhra Pradesh, Rajasthan, most of the this western part, this the residue burning are being done. So this 90% of the residue are being burned in the Punjab, and the burning of 1 ton of rice extra releases 3 kg of particulate matter, 60 kg of carbon monoxide, 1400 kg of carbon dioxide, 199 kg of ash, 2 kg of sulfur dioxide. So these are the, and the loss of organic matter, this is also there by the burning of this crop. And along with this burning, approximately, please mute yourself. Please mute yourself. Ashok Kumar Singh, I think you have not been muted. Dr. Ashok Kumar Singh ji. Yeah. Sasang ji and Dr. Ashok Kumar Singh ji. You have to mute yourself. Approximately 80 to 90% of nitrogen, 25% of phosphorus, 20% of potassium, and 50% of sulfur present in the crop residue are being lost if you are burning. And the burning is also the emission of the trace gases, methane, carbon monoxide, nitrous oxide, oxide of nitrogen, sulfur, all these gases which goes to the environment, and that the that responsible for the environmental pollution. So burning should not be there. And the crop residue, this can be managed very well. If you see in the many rain-fed crop production system, the sum of the area which is the low-yielding areas, the very less residues are there, and which can be satisfy the demand. Please mute yourself. Many irrigated crop residue, crop production system, however, generate too much residue. And the readily manage, this residue can be managed or can be retained.
Sorry, Dr. D. Participant, please mute. Participant, Mr. Sasank.
हाँ, ये बाउंड्री स्टार्ट किया है ये। Why you are disturbing? Mr. Sasang. Please go ahead.
Yeah, please. Some of the people they are not being muted. So that's why this problem is coming. Again, I request to all of you, please mute yourself. Otherwise, it cannot be discussed. So, for low crop residue situation, some residue can be retained and most of the residue can be used as a livestock feed. But in the high residue production system, there is need of alternate economic or judicious use of this residue that is very challenging job. And to develop a conservation agriculture waste seeder or machinery to manage in the high residue production situation. That is the challenge. Because if you see the nutrient available in rice is per hectare, if you are burning, so this much will be the loss. And if you are retaining, then the 39 kg per hectare nitrogen, 14 kg phosphorus, and 140 kg of potassium, 11 kg of sulfur, you are going to be retained into the soil. But their management, proper management is required. Crop residue can be also very good source of organic matter, very good source of carbon. And because organic matter is the key to the productivity, if either you are talking about the productivity or talking about the sustainability, first you have to manage the organic matter, you have to maintain the organic matter into the soil. Crop residue retention on the soil surface substantially reduce the runoff and soil erosion. This is the self-explanatory. Soil evaporation and land preparation cost can be reduced because wherever we are applying the residues, the soil is friable. And even after puddled rice, it is very easy to manage that soil. And we have observed one or two in the organic soil, we are observing one or two plowing or harrowing is one or two harrowing is sufficient after puddled rice. However, in other situation, if you are not applying organic, so the minimum five harrowing is required to manage the soil for the sowing of wheat crop. With the introduction of combined harvester, more than 75% of rice area is harvested mechanically, and that residue can be managed. And this management is the major challenge. There is need to adopt ways and options to manage the crop residue. And what are the ways and options are there, we'll discuss. And the most important thing is whatever I am going to be discussed here, I am adopting. I am adapting. Not only this is the bookish field, this is the bookish thing I am discussing, not the photograph which I have taken from the internet, all these things. This I am doing here because at our farm we are doing more than 1,000 acre land by ourselves, managed by the university at farm and commercial farm other than the research units are there. So at that 500 acre land, 500, it's not too less land, it's a sufficient land, at which we are taking rice wheat system at 500 acre land. And out of 500 acre land, total land, not a single plant of rice, either I have been taken out from the field or I have burned. So all the 100% residue has been incorporated, either retained on the surface or it has been incorporated at our field. And most of the wheat field, wheat are being in the most of the area, wheat are being sown there, and the very good wheat crop is there. Only some scientific backstopping knowledge is required. But such scientific backstopping knowledge is required, we'll discuss later. So the option number one, after harvest of the rice crop, he just cut it, chopped it by the mulcher and spread on the surface. Then you can use reversible plow, moldboard plow, and the soil will be like this. Then on this soil you can sow the wheat crop very well. The only thing is that you have to keep in your mind, at the physiological maturity stage, rice should be irrigated at the physiological, so that the proper moisture should be there. And this, after the moldboard plow, is directly the rice after applying by two harrows. After one moldboard plow, there's two harrow, and the wheat crop can be sown very well. So this is the one option. And you may see here the very good wheat crop is there. Another option is the farmer can use the tractor-driven machinery, residue management, seeder and super seeder is the direct sowing machine, which has been developed for the wheat sowing after harvesting of rice. So approximately 150 acre land or field at our farm, that has been sown by that super seeder only. So we have, and before that just a super seeder sowing, the combine, which is nowadays coming, SMS, system management system, is there with the combine. And the rice are being harvested, all the rice which were here at 500 acre land, it has been harvested through this SMS combine, super SMS combine, super SMS attached. It is the separate unit which has been attached with the combine, which chop the rice extra and spread on. Otherwise, what happened? Most of the places heaps of the rice extra. Please mute yourself, Dr. Ashok Kumar Singh. You please mute yourself, I think. So this separate system which has been attached with the combine, and which chop the extra, harvest rice, chop the extra and spread behind this combine. So the rice should be harvested by this SMS combine, and nowadays these SMS combines are coming, and then this sowing of wheat directly can be done by this super seeder. Super seeder, you may see here, this is sowing, this is chopping the rice extra and sowing out the wheat crop. So this is the very good machinery, but the limitation is that this can sow by this super seeder, it cannot be sown more than 3 to 4 acre per day. So if large area is there, 2-3 super seeder will be required. Otherwise, if up to 10 acre or 20 acre, this by one super seeder it can be managed. 20 acre up to 30 acre it can be managed very well. And within 15 days, if you see approximately up to 40 acre land can be sown. And this just like work as this seed drill, the Fertikum seed drill, fertilizer application directly is there, and the seed chamber and fertilizer chamber, both chamber is there. And I have, as I told, I have sown approximately 150 acre land. And this last year, we are, and this year photograph One is the this year photograph, one is, another is the last year photograph. And by this super season crop at Pandagar farm, productivity level was 54 to 61 quintal per hectare. So it's not a less productivity. It's a very good productivity was there. And this is the average of last year, average of 50 acre from the two plots, average up to 50 acre. It's not only, I'm not doing 1 acre, 2 acre, 3 acre. So whenever I used to talk presently as a CGM, Chief General Manager, so I used to talk in the 100 acres, 200 acres, 300 acres like that. So the very good crop is there, and still this year is also very good crop is there. And this photograph of this year and the last year productivity level was this one, 54 to 61 quintal per hectare. So this is the very good option which can be adapted, and this organic matter, this rice residue can be maintained, retained on the surface, which will be later on responsible for the sufficient supply of sufficient quantity of organic carbon, organic matter, micronutrient, and even the potassium, because all of you, most of the you may be the scientist, you might be knowing that the even potassium only 15%, 15 to 20% translocated to the grain, 50% of nitrogen translocated to the grain, 60% of the phosphorus translocated to the grain, 60 to 70%. Likewise, the micronutrient, all these things. So this, if you are retaining this, so the more than 80% of potassium you are retaining into the soil. More than 30%, 40% of phosphorus you are retaining into the soil. 50% of nitrogen you are going to be retained into the soil. So all this, and not only that, even the physical fertility, physical condition of soil, which support the physical fertility, which support the biological fertility, and later on, which will support also the chemical fertility of the soil. Another option is the direct wheat sowing by the zero till seed drill. So this is zero till, 0-40 seed drill, or then this mulcher, pass a mulcher, then it can be sown. Another option was there after this this mulching, after this, what we had done, we had just irrigated to the field, and directly the harrowing has been done. That was another option. Another option is there in very small area we have done. That's why we have not produced here the data. Next year we'll do that. After this mulching, you have to spray the microbial consortia, which will decompose partially, subside the this residue, and then the harrowing can be done. Another also we have done this just after this mulching, we have harrowed 2 times, and after harrowing only little bit soil will come out because most of the residue then got irrigated. After irrigation, we have sown the wheat crop. So these three, four option is related with the mulching. Either you can direct irrigate it, then harrowing and sowing of the wheat crop, or behind this moldboard plow, you can use directly, or spray the submicrobial consortia, which is responsible for the partial decomposition of the residue, and then irrigate it, then can be applied, or just pass on the 2 harrow, and after 2 harrow, it should be. And I have done this, as I told that out of 500 acre, all the 500 acre, we have managed the residue very well at our farm. So out of that 150 acre sown by the super seeder, some 50 to 100 acre sown by this approximately 50 acres sown by directly moldboard plow. Then we have some spray this consortia, Then we have just after mulching, irrigated the field, and after after the when the field will come into the condition, then we have sown, we have passed the harrow and sown the field. Then just before irrigation, also we have harrowed 2 times and then irrigated, then the sown the. So these are 4-5 options are there. 4 options are there along with the mulching, but mulching must be there through the mulcher before these 4-5 up. Then another, as I told, this is the super seeder. This by this, this can be managed well. Then the direct feed sowing, 0-till seed drill, this is also. So turbo seeder is also coming by this, though I have not used this only, this has come here. From next year, we'll go to demonstration of this turbo seeder also. This is also one of the way to apply this. But along with that, as I told, that is some nutrient management science is there. Not only this, you can go for the super seeder, you can go for the this mold bolt plow, you can go for the other way of the retention of the residue. But the nutrient management along with that residue retention system, that is very important. If you are not able to manage this, you are able to get a good crop. Number one is additional at least 30 kg of nitrogen. So if the recommendation, most of the cases, the recommendation is 150 kg nitrogen, 60 kg phosphorus, and 40 kg of potassium. But with this retention system, residue retention system, you can go for the 180 kg of nitrogen, 60 kg of phosphorus, and 40 kg of potassium. That must be. And NPK, even phosphorus and potassium, you can reduce. That I am going to be develop a system. This phosphorus and potassium you can reduce the rice crop. Then the placement of 50 kg of nitrogen. Please mute yourself. Please mute yourself. The placement of 50 kg of nitrogen along with the phosphorus and potassium as a baser. So at the time of sowing, 50 kg of nitrogen. Suppose if we are applying 2 quintal of NPK, 12, 32, 16 ratio NPK. So 12 into 2 quintal, 24 kg of nitrogen is going through the NPK. Then the 50 kg of nitrogen must be applied along with the NPK at the time of sowing. Then the 75 kg of nitrogen, that must be top dressed at the first top dressing after first irrigation. So that means out of this 180 kg, 30 kg, 80 kg plus 75 kg, 80 kg plus 75 kg. So that means 155 kg nitrogen must be applied up to the first irrigation, means up to the 25 days of sowing. Otherwise, we have observed if the wheat crop will be in the stress of either of water or of nitrogen stress at the initial stage, then the penalty will be there. So it must be, and if anyhow, if you are delaying that the 25 days after sowing, so that means the crop will come into the stress situation, nitrogen stress situation. Because what happened, and that I have done in the laboratory also, I have done that experiment in the laboratory also. What happened, if you are retaining the residue on the surface, so after first irrigation, it will totally contact into the soil. So surface CN ratio will be increased. And if the surface CN ratio will be increased, then the microbial jump up there, their microbial population jump up there. Microbial population, bacterial population will jump there. And the bacteria, because here the CN ratio, bacteria's CN ratio is 8:1. So to maintain that, immobilization will be there. So the native available nitrogen will be taken by the bacteria and the crop will come into the nitrogen esters, which should not be there. So this is the biggest science, not much big science, but the biggest science in terms of application. If you are not able to manage this, so you will not able to harvest the optimum productivity. Then the rest of the 25 kg of nitrogen after second irrigation. So it may be reduced up, maybe at the 50 kg you may placement may be done 25 kg, but 75 kg must be at the time of first top dressing, that should be there. Otherwise, your crop will not be a good crop. Wheat crop will not be a good crop. And I have seen, it's my own experience, one of the plot, anyhow, it has been delayed by 35 days. So the crop has come into the esters. Crop is not very good. And the, some of the our research units also, some of the, my friends are there. They have also adopted this super seeder, but their crop is not good because they were not able to manage the whatever managed by this way. Whatever I have managed here at them. So their crop is very, very, very poor. Even last year, it was also hardly 2.5 ton per hectare, but I have harvested 5.4 to 6 ton per hectare of the wheat due to of management of this level of nutrient. That is very, very, very much necessary. And you have to irrigate first irrigation, even it is recommended 21 to 22 days or up to, but don't go for that. You irrigate at 18 days after the sowing. So the first irrigation, 18 days after sowing, after 2-3 days, you just apply the 75 kg, means approximately 1.5 quintal of 1.5 quintal of urea per hectare. Otherwise, the wheat crop will be into the estrus. This is also one of the results I have taken from the IRI-PNI CIMIT collaboration research at IRI, wherever the residue retention is there. So wheat nitrogen use efficiency, that is increased. Then the other way of residue also can be managed, the tractor-driven mulchers, rake, baler, that can be used simultaneously for the crop residue management, for the following purposes, the animal feeding, mulching for the orchard crop, biogas production, paper and rope industry, packaging material, this can be also, means make a bale. So I have also, it's not only, it's not, I have not purchased, but it has been supplied for the one of the tractor company, that is the New Highland. I have purchased 10 tractor from the New Highland. So the New Highland, they have given me one rack and baler machine. So so this is also one of the option. If you are not retaining at the farm, so the baling can be done and this can be used for the purposes which I have already been told. So this is the conclusion. The recycling of crop residue has the great potential to return the considerable amount of plant nutrients to the soil. Incorporation of crop residue into the soil or retention on the surface has several positive influences, physical, chemical, biological property. We are seeing it's not a property, even in the organic farming system, I'm looking after here organic farming system also. We used to say the physical fertility, chemical fertility and biological fertility because it's very much interlinked. So the physical fertility means the physical property, the proper physical property will be there, physical fertility will be there. So the soil biological activity is the very much related to the physical property of the soil. So, and this physical and biological, both the fertility is responsible for the chemical fertility. Means availability of the nutrient. So incorporation of residue, crop residue in the conservation agriculture has the direct and indirect effect on the pest, that's also there. The crop residue of the great economic value as a livestock feed, fuel, industrial, raw material, conservation agriculture, all these things. So either can be, means residue should not be burned, either it should be retained on the surface, incorporated into the soil, that will be much better. Otherwise, it can be baled out, it can be sold out, it can be used as for the livestock feed, for the industrial purposes, all these things. So thank you very much. If you have any query, any question, any clarification.
Thank you, sir. Dear participants, now you can post your question in chat box or you can ask directly.
Dr. Pandiraj?
Yes, sir.
I think there is no question.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Is there a question?
Sir, dear participants, okay. Do you have any query?
Okay, you raise the question.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir, for an enlightening and entertaining presentation on the right way to adoption of better agronomical measures alternative to crop burning. Sir, you elaborated practical knowledge of management of nutrients in a residue retained field. We appreciate having this mysterious area clarified, sir. Sir, you elucidated all the slides that you brought us live visit into your Panthnagar farm. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Yes.
Thank sir, you for inviting me. Such a very good burning aspect of the crop management. Thank you very much.